But if you are establishing yourself as a personal brand, I would brand your name just in case you want to change careers, courses, you want to pivot. One time I was going to be Brittany the vlogger. Thank God that didn't work out. I've tried to change. I've tried, but everything just kept coming back to Brittany the host. So maybe that's God. But I would highly recommend anybody that is starting a business, like I said, or wanting to brand themselves, brand you. Don't brand what you do unless you absolutely, that's your bread and butter.
Welcome to the Your Podcast Mentor Show with Jonathan Jones. Here you will learn how to start, launch, and monetize your podcast. In addition to hearing the latest trends and the latest and greatest things happening in the podcast industry. Are you ready? What's going on, family? Welcome to the Your Podcast Mentor Show. And you all know this is your number one source for podcast news, podcast how-tos, and also interviews. And you are, I'm excited today to have a long lost friend. That's what we're gonna say. have a long lost friend on the show. And we're just gonna dive in. We're not gonna really do introductions because we're gonna just give the opportunity for you to share that as we dive in through this thing. But we have the one and the only Brittany Daniel, aka Brittany the host. Brittany, how you feeling?
Thank you. Hey, I'm great, Jonathan. Thank you so much for having me. Thank you for sharing your audience. I hope you guys are blessed and are just having an amazing day. But thank you for allowing me to join. I appreciate it.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, so I definitely wanted you to join because like we were talking about earlier offline, like you have one of these things that a lot of people want, and you have one of these things that people are like striving to build and to grow. And I'm talking about your community. Brittany, talk a little bit about talk a little bit about that, because you're talking about the Morning Motivation Crew. Talk to us, Brittany. Talk to us. Write that down.
Yeah. Well, thank you, Jonathan. Well, I'm a host of Morning Motivation, which we go live every single weekday, Monday through Friday at 8 a.m. Eastern on YouTube. I was broadcasting on Facebook. I feel like people got to come to YouTube to join the conversation. And it's also part of the Brittany the Host podcast. So if you can't join live, you can always listen there. But I've been on YouTube, but people don't know, that haven't followed my journey or who don't know who I am. I've been on YouTube for almost 8 years now. So throughout my time on YouTube, my audience, the fam has seen me move across the country multiple times, have tried things, have went to grad school, failed grad school. They see me through my highs and lows, my ups and downs, my relationship struggles. They've seen my whole life. But earlier this year, you know, my content, I was having a hard time. Like, I didn't want to just continue to do the same thing I kept seeing. And I know that the landscape of YouTube was changing. And so shout out to Think Media TV, great resource. If you are a creator, go over to Think Media TV. They give a lot of great gems. And one of the things that they said was, hey, start a live show. And I'm Brittany the host. And I was like, that makes a lot of sense. Like, I'm Brittany the host. I want to host a show. Why not do a live show? I cannot stand editing. I hate editing. I'm good at it, but I don't like doing it. So I was just like, that will be perfect for me. That's what I was doing on my podcast before I brought it visually. I was just going rogue, no editing on my podcast. Mm-hmm. The first two seasons, year one and two, it used to be the Brittany the Host podcast. Is, if you know, you know, right? You go, they're still up there on Spotify and all of that great stuff. But I just was, I prayed about it. I asked God, I said, God, I know that this is, the landscape is changing. Live is the new thing. What do I do? What kind of show do I bring? And he gave me the vision of Morning Motivation. He was like, I want you to talk about spirituality. I want you to talk about bettering people. I want you to help people. And I was like, okay. I said, well, when do I do it? Once a week. And I got confirmation. He said, every day. I said, wait. Hold on, God. You know, when God gives you a message, sometimes we don't want to listen to it. I was like, Lord, every day, I ain't do nothing every day. He said, every day. He said, yes, every day. So I made it a commitment to God to try my best. I'm not perfect. You know, there were some days the internet went down. One day I got sick. So, but almost every single day, 150 episodes, Monday through Friday, I went live with my audience. And when I say my morning motivator showed up and showed out every day, and if you guys listen, and for those of you who know, you hear the names every day because I shout them out in the live stream. So if you join live, you get a shout out. Come in and say good morning. But it, just building, having that consistency, keeping that that what God has told me to do on a consistent basis every day has allowed me to build that audience. When you show up, people will show up for you.
Wow. Absolutely. Wow. So that's like half a year, Brittany.
Yeah. I've been from January 4th was the first episode that dropped of the Morning Motivation, and we've been going strong ever since. Now, so a couple, I missed maybe two or three. Sickness. One day my internet went out, or if it was a holiday. But I can count on one hand how many times we didn't go live through the week. But Monday through Friday, every single weekday, 8 a.m., we're live.
Oh, my goodness. You inspire me right now. Lord have mercy. And I do one episode a week, but goodness. Okay. 150 episodes strong.
Welcome. My name is Brittany Daniel, and this is 10 Keys to Consistency and Discipline. Over the next 10 modules, you will learn the practical tips that I use to keep discipline and consistency in my life without losing my feminine touch, okay? Because we got to keep that. So if you are over burning out, if you have several goals that you want to tackle, and for whatever reason, you're not getting them done, or you find yourself working way more than you want to, and you want to learn how to do work-life balance, then this is the course for you. Over the next 10 modules, I will break it down easy peasy lemon squeezy. And in this course, you get an ebook along with affirmations that will help you along your journey, give you the confidence you need to work your goals. You really take the time to truly invest in yourself because you are worth it and you deserve it. The best investment you can make is yourself. And I know that this course will give you practical tools to help you get closer to your goals and co-create the life you want with God in mind.
No, Brittany, don't make no excuses for me. Don't make no excuses for me. Okay.
You do what you can. As long as you're consistent. That's okay. Everybody's schedule is different. Don't compare. You are doing great. Everybody, as long as you show up consistently for your goal, you're doing great.
I got you. So God told you to go live every day.
That's how I felt. That's the confirmation I got. Yes. Yeah.
But what is it that keeps you going even when you don't feel like getting on and doing it? Because I'm sure there's somebody out there who's like, I mean, I heard what Brittany said. You know, she going live every day. I heard John do an episode a week, whatever it might be. And we're not comparing. But what is the thing that pushes you into that discipline versus I don't feel like it, so I'm not going to do it?
This is my personal conviction. And it's basically, I always tell the morning motivators or anybody that joins me, do you want to get to the end of your life and have God look through his spiritual iPad is what I say and say, hey, I had something for you, but you didn't follow this step. Remember, I told you to do this. You didn't do it. Scrolling like, oh, I had stuff for you, but you didn't do it. And so what it was just the commitment of, if I do my part, faith without works is dead, right? If I do my part, then I'm praying that God will deliver and show up. It's never in our time, but it's his time. And I had such a strong conviction about what he led me to do. And I had no excuse. I'm self-employed at the moment. And although the money wasn't, you know, YouTube is fickle. If you're a social media influencer and you don't have hundreds and thousands of views, everybody knows I don't, but I have a core audience, but it's fickle. So that's scary as well too, but knowing and keeping going, like, cause if I were to stop or not show up, then maybe I wouldn't get what I'm promised. And one thing that confirmed it for me, it was months into it. I heard, Tabitha Brown, shout out to Miss Tab. She said, she had the same conviction one day to go live each and every day. And she said she did it for 2 years and nobody showed up, but look at her life now. So I was just like, okay, if we stick to it, just put our heads down and just do it every whatever you're convicted to do. If we just listen to God, and that's what I call obedience, stick to it, then hopefully, you know, we get the better end of the stick. That's kind of just how I've kept going. And then you got to pick your hard. And not to make this long-winded, but I heard one of my really good friends, her mom told her, she said she was struggling with her weight. Her weight was going up and down. And she was like, oh, I don't want to go to the gym, right? She was like, oh, it's so hard. I gained the weight I lost. She was like, I don't want to keep going. And her mom looked at her and said, she said, pick your hard. Shout out to Taylor. tailor things. Her mom said, pick your hard. Yeah, it might be hard to go to the gym, but what's harder? You not getting to your goal and not achieving your weight. So I always tell my morning motivators and myself, pick your hard. Yeah, it might be hard to get up, but what's harder? Disappointing yourself later down the road, not achieving your goals, delaying God's promise for you, or just doing it and then being like, well, Lisa did it, you know? So that's what kind of keeps me going every day.
Wow. I love it. Okay. So when I was on your channel, I was checking out your videos and, you know, everything that you were breaking down. So I got a couple of YouTube questions. I got to ask you, Brittany. So, you said you talk about, you know, the faith aspect. I know you talk a little bit about relationship. How do you decide like what needs to be talked about?
That's interesting. Twofold. The first thing that comes to mind is, am I being called to say something? You know, because everything doesn't need to be said. And I'm learning through my content and what I put out, what type of energy I'm receiving back. And if I don't like the energy I'm receiving for saying it, like I have a couple videos that I've put on my Patreon, because I'm like, you know what? Even though that's my opinion and that's what I believe, everything doesn't always need to be vocalized out. So I was just like, let me pull that back. I'm not feeling that energy and I'm just going to put it back here. But my folks who know, they can go, you know, peep my opinion on that. So that's something to think about. And then, so prayer, figuring out, hey, God, am I supposed to speak on this? You know, and then two, I would say the other fold is value. You know, think about your ideal customer, your audience. What are they struggling with? What do they need help with? A lot of my coaching clients, I'm a certified life coach. A lot of them are struggling with accountability. You know, they're spiritual, but they want to up their conversation or their relationship with God. They want to feel better about themselves. They want to know that the mistakes that they made, that they can learn from them and they're really not mistakes, and how to help them turn their life around, or they've given up and they need some hope. Or so you just have to figure out, who's your audience? Who draws to you? Interject. Who draws to you? Who do you serve? And where can you help? What is your area of expertise that you can give knowledge to? Because let's just keep it a buck. There, we got enough people talking about celebrities, and I've entertained some of that stuff too. You know, as teaching moments and things like that. But we have enough of that. So, where can you or anybody watching use what you know, your knowledge, and give back to your community? Maybe it's financial advice. You know, one of my biggest, most successful videos on my YouTube channel that almost has 1 million views was just me teaching people how to budget and save on a very basic level, because I was like, well, I wasn't taught. So maybe people out there may want to know this. And so very basic. And I've had people tell me, you started my journey. I didn't know how to budget before I watched that video. So think about the things that you know how to do, even if they're very simple. Even if you got it, like clockwork, that's your secret sauce to help people and to just add value. So the first thing, pray about it, make sure that's what you're supposed to be doing. And then second is, where can you serve your audience, and what do you know that's valuable to help them in their lives?
That's good. I like that. Because one, it shows you take it out of your hands in a sense, because you put it in God's hands. It's like, hey, what you got for me? Well, I'm supposed to tell the people. And then from the experiences that you've had, then, you know, that allows you to be able to speak on those areas and those topics. That's real. I like that. Okay. Fair enough. Okay. This is the last YouTube question. We're gonna move on, Brittany.
No. Whatever you want. I got you.
Well, I'm saying because it's, you know, because now, you know, we're declared in a recession once again, right? I'm not sure if it's fear mongering or what's going on, but I mean, it's, you know, we've had the second quarter or whatever, that the numbers aren't looking that great. So people are, you know, the creator.
Yeah, we're not spending.
Yeah, that's all. Yeah. And, you know, the creator economy is definitely at an uproar and at a rise.
Yeah.
I'm not saying that there's a perfect YouTube formula out here.
Yes.
But Brittany, I do know you're just shy of 100K YouTube subscribers. Mm-hmm. What's the formula, Brittany? What's your formula to grow a YouTube channel? Like, I need to know. I need to know.
Well, I want to be very transparent. Subscribers do not equal dollar amounts, depending on your platform and depending on what your audience is. It's all about conversion. It's all about percentages, right? So I'm going to be 100% transparent. When I changed my content, I started losing viewers. When I started focusing more on God, when I started doing morning motivation, everybody wasn't into it. I've grown up a lot. When I started my channel, I was 26, 27, around that time. I'm going to be 34 next week. So I've evolved as a person. The things that I'm into that I used to like, I'm not into anymore. YouTube and social media has changed so much since we started years ago. So yes, I have a big audience, but now my core audience is a lot smaller. And what I would say to anybody that's building a platform, do not worry about subscribers. Worry about the people that keep coming to you. Worry about the viewers. Worry about the people who are continuously feeding your soul. Because to be 100% honest, Jonathan, I wish I had less subscribers and more views. Mm. Because views are interaction, views are engagement. And what I'm experiencing now, just being fully transparent, is I do have a lot of subscribers, but my views are down. And so business-wise, outside looking in, it doesn't look that sexy. It doesn't look that like, ooh, she's doing that great. But one thing that I will tell anybody to do is why you focus on who is coming, because that you get quality over quantity. Back in the day, everybody pushed the subscribe button. Now people are being more selective with their subscribes. Back in the day, I like one video, I'm going to push a subscribe. I got on the train where everybody was just subscribing. Now I'm whittling down to my core audience. So I would say the secret sauce to gaining over time is just consistency, is the discipline, is making sure that this is what you want, not because you think that you're going to get a whole bunch of money, because I'm telling you that it doesn't always equal that, mm-hmm. and that you're doing it to serve and you're doing it to add value to other people's lives. Either you're entertaining, you're educating, or you're informing something in the sort. Not just that you think it's going to be a fast cash grab, because it's not. You still have to, it's still a business. You still have to set up your automations. And I'm a coach, I have clients, I have eBooks and digital products. All of that stuff still has to run too. So there are people that are making a lot of money just off social media. I'm just not that person. My money comes from other sources. So the subscribers look great. It's a great, like a billboard, like, hey, but it doesn't always equal money. And again, it's what really matters are the people who view you, that connect with you, that you add value to. That's really your secret sauce, not your subscriber count, because that doesn't always equal true audience, true core audience, for sure.
I got you. Yeah. And I can appreciate your transparency for one. But even in addition to that, really just making sure that we normalize some things in society and in the economy and across the industry. So thank you for that, Brittany, just being real with the people, you know, being real, you know what I'm saying? So because alluded to earlier, you're talking about consistency and one of the areas I know why I've been able to be consistent. It's because of, like, you know, over time I've read certain personal development books. I've gotten with different coaches. Mm-hmm. Like in your journey of consistency, I know, isn't this something that you're really working to help more people with and really mm-hmm. striving towards to, you know, help more people lock in on the goals that they have for themselves?
Absolutely. Consistency. I know it's a broken record. I know people out there like, oh, nails on the chalkboard. Shut up with those two words. It is the secret sauce to getting anything that you want. The reason being is because it doesn't equal success, because you can be consistent in the wrong area and still land up. So it's not the secret to success. It's your secret sauce to discovering what you are called to do and what you're supposed to do. Because if you continue to do something, you can figure out, huh, it doesn't work. Or you can sit back and be like, dang, I wish. Like, if you want to start a YouTube channel, I always tell people, just do it. two things are going to happen. You're either going to figure out that you fall in love with it, you love it, that you have so much value to give to people, it's another stream of income, you can make money, or you're going to figure out it's not for me. But the only way you do it is if you try and you're consistent with the process. And then if it is something that you want to do, that consistency and discipline is going to keep you when you're not motivated, when you don't feel like it, when you are anxious, when you're like, oh, it's not moving fast enough. It's going to build this muscle of resiliency of, as long as I keep going one foot at a time, one brick by brick, I see something coming. Okay. It ain't moving how I want it to move, but I see you, God. You know, it just starts piece by piece, and it really helps you appreciate the journey. But if we just start and stop, pick it up months later, start and stop, you never know what could have or couldn't have come from that, because we didn't have the consistency of proof and you know, the validity of what we've done. It's all been inconsistent. So consistency is key in everything. So I am helping people. I have an ebook dropping next week along with a course on my birthday, August 24th. Shout out to all my Virgos, Leo cusp, you know. But I am dropping that just to help people with just easy steps. My ebooks are not filled with fluff. It's meat and potatoes of, here are the steps that I've taken to be consistent. Here are the steps I've taken to not give up. Here's what you can do. Here's how you can structure your schedule. Here's how you can just rework a few areas in your life and get those systems going so that consistency is easier for you. And it's like, oh, I'm tripping off this. This ain't nothing. I could do this. That's what it's all about.
I love it. So what was it that made you say that now is the time for the book? Like, you're like, now it's time. Like, it's time for this book to come out. These people need this message right now.
My coaching clients were one of the biggest things that I kept noticing in my onboarding with just communicating with them is they needed help with consistency. They needed help with accountability. They needed help with their discipline. That was something that was a trend. And so that's what happens when you serve a consistent audience, or when you show up for people, they trust you. They trust you. So then they're willing to tell you, you know, what they're struggling with. Because if you show your audience, or you show whoever you're serving, you're consistent and you're showing up, they're like, oh, that person's consistent. Maybe they can help me with being consistent. Maybe they can help me with my discipline. Or if you're a great cook, oh, that person could cook really well. Maybe they can help me cook. You know, you have to lead by example, especially as a thought leader, especially as a quote unquote influencer or anybody with a platform. You are a leader. You have a platform. Too much is given, much is required. So when you show up for your audience and they trust you, then they're able to say, you know what, this is something I'm struggling with too. Can you help me? And I just started seeing a consistent pattern. I'm like, hey, let me just throw a course together. Let me throw an ebook. Maybe people can't get the coaching, but at least I can help in this regard. So that's what really prompted me in my birthday launch. Business-wise, anybody out there, business tip, when it's your birthday or a big thing coming up, it's a great time to launch. People will support. Even if they don't care about the course, they'll support you because it's your birthday and they rock with you. So, hey, here it is. So it's a great time to launch. So my birthday just gave me a little bit more motivation to say, you know what, get this out for your people, add value. It's my birthday gift to the world for them showing up for me. Here's something else I can do and add and give you value. Absolutely.
Yeah. I mean, that's a genius hack. I mean, the birthday hack is genius. It's genius. Cause what, that's like the time where, you know, on your page, whatever social media you use, if people, you know, if you use social media people, but you know, that's where you get all that engagement. You get all that activity. It's just an extra surge because it's your birthday.
Absolutely. You got to take advantage of it. It's like Black Friday, New Year's, Christmas. You got to take advantage of those little times because people don't care when it ain't your birthday. When it's your birthday, they'll pay you attention.
A lot of times people don't care. Which is very sad. It's very, very sad. Oh, man.
If you go out with a sequins dress on and it is not your birthday, everybody's going to look at you like, why is she got the sequin dress on a Wednesday? But if it's your birthday, have at it. You can do whatever you want to do on your birthday. Do whatever you want.
is that what you do on Wednesday? On Wednesday, on your birthday, you wear the sequins dress? That's what you do?
I might. You know what? I think I will on Morning Motivation. I might show up in my birthday dress. Absolutely. Absolutely. You can do whatever you want on your birthday. One day a year, one day.
Oh man, that's hilarious. That's hilarious. Okay, so you go by Brittany the host. Mm-hmm. When did you decide like to make this, like when did you say put me here? Like I'm rocking out. I'm the hostess with the mostest. Y'all need me. Like when did that become your thing? Because putting a name on yourself is one of those things where a lot of people are fearful because like mm-hmm. if I put my name out there, then people might think this, that.
You locked in. Yeah.
Talk to me, Brittany.
I don't recommend it. I don't recommend branding yourself to something so permanent only because unless you know, right? Unless you're a lawyer, unless that's your thing. Because it does. Like anytime I wanted to pivot, anytime I wanted to change, I've always reverted, hey, you Brittany the host. You built a brand off of this. But to go back, it really started off my love for television, talk shows. I was the biggest Real fan. Still am a huge The Real fan. I'm so sad it got canceled. I thought I was going to be one of the hosts. But there's an actress named Brittany Daniel with my exact name. We have the exact initials. We have the same middle initial. She's the actress on The Game, Jason Pitt's wife. Her name, we have the same name. And when I would Google, I would try to find myself on YouTube and she would always pop up. And I was like, okay, well, she's Brittany Daniel, the actress. I can be Brittany, the host. So that's kind of how I differentiated myself because we have the exact same name. I wanted people to be able to find me. And that's how I did it because we're both Brittany Daniel, spelled the exact same way. And I love her. I think she's dope. But I got to get my piece too, right? So that's kind of how I said, okay, she's an actress. I want to be a host. Brittany the host. And I've been rocking with it for a while. People even call me that sometimes. Like, hey, that's Brittany the host, which is funny. But I would really, really think to anybody with a business or if you want to start a personal brand, think long term. You might not want to be a host. You might have wanted to be a host at 26. You might not want to be a host in your 30s. It is a long life dream of mine. So if it happens, great. I will always host a show or host something. I love hosting birthdays and things like that. So it's fine for me. But if you are establishing yourself as a personal brand, I would brand your name just in case you want to change careers, courses, you want to pivot. One time I was going to be Brittany the vlogger. Thank God that didn't work out. I've tried to change. I've tried, but everything just kept coming back to Brittany the host. So maybe that's God. But I would highly recommend anybody that is starting a business, like I said, or wanting to brand themselves, brand you. Don't brand what you do unless you absolutely, that's your bread and butter.
The Brittany Daniel.
Hey.
Hey. You know, just using, I'm using what you just gave me. Just, you know.
That's why I always say, hey, it's Brittany Daniel. I always say Brittany Daniel, just so they know my name, just in case.
Yeah. Well, that's pretty neat, though. I mean, because having the dreams and the aspiration for being a host, I think that's pretty neat. Because, mm-hmm. I mean, I don't know if I hear that too often. I don't hear that too often, actually. I mean,
I see it now.
So you know, just being in that place.
I see it a lot now. I see people. I'm like, okay, I see. Because there wasn't nobody doing that when I did it. I'm not saying I was the first, but shout out to all the girlies who took some notes. I got you. I love it. I love it for everybody.
What do you say to the person who says the industry is oversaturated? Like let's say we mm-hmm. are talking about the hosting mm-hmm. space and somebody's saying, but I mm-hmm. want to be a host. I've always wanted to be a host. I got inspired by, you know, whoever, Ricky Lake, Geraldo. I'm saying all the old people.
Brittany the host. Yeah. Oprah, me. Yeah.
Brittany the host. You know, what about the people like, I want to do it, but it's oversaturated. What you got to say for them, Brittany?
If it's your gift, if it calls you, if it's something that you do naturally and you love it, do it. I could go back to what we see on Instagram and they always say, look at how many bread companies there are. Look at how many milk companies there are. Look at how many pizzas they make. There's always variety, but you are going to bring something different that I can't do. You know, Jonathan's podcast is going to be different. We could talk about the same topic. Jonathan's going to have another point of view than I am. Both both point of views are valuable. He's going to attract one audience. I'm going to attract another audience. So there's always somebody out there for you, especially if you're providing value. If you care about people in an audience, I would not say to do it just because you think you're going to get a whole bunch of money overnight. It's like anything, right? Nothing happens overnight that's worth having. So if it's not your passion, if it's something that you just like, think about it, just try it. You know, if it's something you're dabbling with, try. But if you really have a yearning to be a host, the only way you can host is by doing it. You know, you can't just walk up. There's no job applications. You can't apply for these things. People have to either hire you from word of mouth, from your experience, from what they've seen of you already. So you have to give social proof. You know, I the way I get invited on podcasts and things like that is because I already have a platform. So you can't be a host without some sort of experience, real social proof that this is what you do. You're good at it. Nobody's going to hire you or pay you to get on stage and they never heard you speak. It normally doesn't work like that. You have to do a couple free things in order to get, you know, the video content and the social proof that this is what I do and I'm good at what I do. And the more you do it, the more confident you'll become. This did not happen overnight. People say, oh, you do it so well. It took years. I've always loved it. But if y'all go back to my old Facebook and I used to go live on Facebook all the time, every day at like 10 a.m. You know, I've grown into this by just continuously, consistently honing my skills. So you have to host in order to be a host. It's not something you can just wake up one morning and apply for a job and you're a host now. So I would just tell anybody who wants to be a host, start hosting. Pitch yourself. If you see events coming up, ask them, do they need a host? I host parties. I hosted Jay LaCorion and Keisha K. Lee's course launch. I will say, call people, hey, do you need a host for your event? I host events. I host my own things. I host a show. I host a podcast. If you want to host, you have to host. And then eventually you'll get paid and invited. Takes a little time, but you have to do it in order for people to take you seriously. Absolutely do it. I say go for it. Just try it. What's the worst that can happen?
I love the way how you gave like a rundown and like a framework. You gave like a rough framework of like what it takes to be successful as a host, but really what it takes to be successful in business. And I think so often people, like, they fast forward like past what you said, and they fast forward past where you used to do this on this platform, and you used to be here and you used to be there. And they're like, oh, but I see where she is now. It's like, no, you can't. This ain't the movies. You can't fast forward through the previews at the house. You know, this ain't Netflix, this ain't Hulu. You know what I'm saying? So just wanted to lay that out, because I think that was really, really valuable. And I don't know. I thought of this question just as we were talking, and because I was thinking initially of, like, you know, myths, because you talked about ultimately your background, and you talked about like what it takes to build the platform that you have today. I'm curious to hear from you, Brittany, and thinking about, you know, when people see your content and, you know, they listen to the podcast, what is one thing, or like if somebody met you in person and they heard your comment, like, what's one thing where they ran up and they're like, Brittany, I didn't think you were going to be like this. Or I thought, because I know you've got it before, where people ran up and they're like, oh, you're much nicer than I thought.
Mm-mm. I always get you're exactly who you are. I'm the same, cool, chill, non-confrontational. I try not to travel like Jesus, help me. But I am just, this is who I am. I'm authentic. That's what I get most of all. Like, I'm the same person offline than I am online. I watch my words more. Like, if you see me in person, I'm probably even chiller. I always tell people I'm better in person. You like me online, you're going to love me in person. Because that's when I get to take it off and we can really talk and kiki. But I would say authenticity. Like, you have to be yourself. It takes too much work to put up a front. And of course, like, when you're in a social setting or you're online, of course you want to put your best foot forward, right? It's like a date. People don't know you. You don't really know them. So like an interview, you always want to put your best foot forward, but you can't be fake. You cannot be. People can see through it. The cameras will show that you're being fake. It just, authenticity is everything. And I always try to tell my audience, I'm not perfect. You know, I also share, especially on my Patreon, I share my struggles, what I'm going through, yeah, I might be great in these sectors of life, but I'm not doing so hot in these sectors of life. So I never try to make it seem like I'm better than anybody. I'm not more knowledgeable or smarter. No, I'm just a person that has been called to do something, and everybody is valuable and unique in their own way. And that's always your secret sauce. So I would just, I feel like authenticity is more so than anything. I'm the same. If you knew me in college, I'm the same person. Just wiser, got better standards and more boundaries, but I'm the same person.
Understood.
Yeah, absolutely.
Understood. Yeah, I'm with you. I'm with you on that. I'm with you on that. And college, man, college is interesting. Okay, that's all I'm gonna say. Anyway, we're gonna transition. So we have this. Segment on the show, because I think you really set it up nicely. But we have this segment on the show. I do like a couple rapid fire questions. Ooh. Just like to have a little fun. So the people can, you know, just see just a different side of you.
Okay.
So Brittany, are you ready?
Yes.
It's rapid fire, and it's basically this or that.
Okay.
Right. So you're gonna be like one or the other.
Okay.
Wait. Had to set you up for success. Okay, but here we go.
Yes.
Okay, here we go. Ketchup or ranch?
Ooh, ranch.
Okay. Phone in the bathroom or no phone in the bathroom?
Oh, phone in the bathroom. Gotta check social media on the phone. Not in the bathroom. I have to.
Do you sort by price or you sort by rating?
Both. I can't. Price.
Okay.
You said by rating, like reviews?
Yeah, like rating and reviews, yeah.
Right. Oh, price all day. My numbers, girl.
Gotcha. Netflix or Hulu?
Ooh, Netflix.
Okay. Crunchy peanut butter or smooth peanut butter?
Smooth.
Cooking or cooking for?
Oh, like somebody's cooking for me?
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, cooking for. Yes, absolutely. Okay. Cook for me.
Okay. Rich and famous or rich and unknown?
Ooh, rich and unknown. Absolutely.
Okay, and then last question. Lose sleep or skip a meal?
Skip a meal. I do that daily. Oh. I do that daily with my sleep needs.
Okay, there you go.
I like that.
Okay,
that was it.
That was painless. It didn't hurt.
I like it.
a little rapid fire. And this is just the icing on the cake. Just a little bonus question.
Ooh.
Who is one slept on podcaster that you feel more people need to know about?
There is a pod. Oh, I have a couple. I can't just give you one. There's two for sure. Our two sisters podcast. Two young ladies from London. I absolutely, their conversations are so intelligent. They're so articulate. And when I say articulate, we're all articulate, right? It's not about color or anything like that. It's about just their thought process and the way they have banter towards one another. And I love, because we hear Americans all day, that is from another country, from another perspective. And it just shows us that most of us folks of color go through the same thing. So shout out to the Two Sisters podcast. Oh, so, 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 so good. Very intelligent. If you like intelligent women that have real conversations about what's going on with women and with toxic with healing and relationships and development, all of that stuff, 100% recommend. They're also on YouTube. All your podcasts, I watch them on YouTube, and they're on TikTok as well. It's how I discovered them. So shout out to the Two Sisters to Our Sisters podcast. And then another one for creators that a lot of creators sleep on is Making Moves by TK. TK is a creator. She's a YouTube creator. YouTube content creator outside of our space, if you know what I mean. She's a YouTube content creator that was actually working for another creator, a larger creator named Alicia Marie, and she's cultivated her brand kind of not alongside but after her. And the knowledge that she has, she brings people in the industry, other creators, and they talk about the business side of YouTube and that a lot of people don't talk about. She gives a lot of tips and a lot of gems for especially young girls or young people who are trying to break into the industry. She went to school for it. Just very, very smart and intelligent conversations about business, about being a creator. And then one more. So, shout out to TK. And then One more, if you are a creator, Think Media TV gives you all the game and knowledge from streaming to what cameras to use. They give you the latest and greatest YouTube updates. So if you want to be a YouTuber in any industry, no matter if you want to be, if you want to focus on Instagram or any social media, you have to learn all of the nuances, the changes. It can be annoying because they're changing so much so fast, but having that knowledge, because you have to keep up or you're going to get left behind. So those three for sure. Think Media TV on YouTube, Making Moves with TK, shout out to her, and To Our Sisters podcast. Three, chef's kiss. Chef's kiss, absolutely.
There it is. There it is. Well, man, Brittany, thank you so much for taking the time to come bless the show. You gave a lot of game. You gave us, you talked about, you know, the YouTube, you talked about just the consistency. Then you came back and talked about the framework for basically building a successful business, or at least starting one. And then you gave us some extra game on the end, you know what I'm saying? And then you let us see you in the rapid fire section. So please let everybody know how they can find you, follow you, connect with you at this time.
Yes, absolutely. So you can find everything about me on BrittanyTheHost.com. Links to all of my YouTube channel, my podcast, everything is there. Also, you can check me out on YouTube by just putting Brittany Daniel or Brittany the Host. I stream live on my podcast. You have Spotify, Apple Music, Google Podcasts, and follow me on Instagram at Brittany the Host. Link in my bio gives you so many resources to what I provide, what I offer. And if you are looking for a life coach, you can get a 30-minute free session with me, where we can see if I'm a good fit, we can work together. And don't forget, I launch my Consistency and Discipline ebook next Wednesday, or Wednesday coming up on August 24th. So make sure you guys get a copy.
There it is. There it is. Brittany, thank you once again. Thank you once again. Definitely enjoyed our conversation. And everybody out there, be sure to show up and show support, because Brittany is pouring into the community. She be pouring out her heart, y'all, in the morning. Like, she just be passionate with the book club she got going and everything like that with the morning motivation. So one, subscribe to her channel. Two, make sure to tap in, like she said, with the ebook coming out and the course and everything like that. And you all know that we're your number one source here for podcast news, podcast how-tos, and interviews. Until next time, peace and God bless.